grensoverschrijdende samenwerking, prima, fijn, ook belangrijk. Maar dan wel met data, met onderzoek. Wat scheidt ons, wat bindt ons en wat kunnen we daaruit leren? In Nederland wordt dat al onderdeel van beleid. En misschien is dat ook de bedoeling, juist een aanbeveling, om dat ook internationaal in Europa nog veel meer te doen. En ITEM heeft inderdaad die methodiek ontwikkeld. En nu ga ik schakelen naar het Engels, omdat we ook internationale gasten bij ons hebben. I'm very glad to have you with me here today. Reiner Steffens of the European Committee of the Regions. Nathalie Verschelde is bij ons from the European Commission's DG Regio. En Martin Unfried is Senior Researcher at ITEM. Martin, first of all, the importance of data. That's what we're talking about. Might be an odd question to scientists, but what is the importance of data within ITEM?
I mean, the first question we always get, if there is a problem, how many people are affected, for instance?
Exactly.
And so this is the first most difficult question very often, because there is no data about, for instance, at the moment, how many cross-border workers are really working at home and what are the expectations for them. So this is a typical example where you really need good data in order to make also assessments about policy.
Who decides topics on your cross-border examination, on those examinations and research?
Yeah, I was also very happy with Mr. Donner's speech, because he said there is also a need for, in the first place, to better know the problem, and then also to know your priorities and to know who has the capacity to solve the problem. And that's more or less what we are trying to do, bottom up. Every year we have a panel of people from Grensinfopunten, cross-border information points, or from our whole network, and we ask what are their proposals on the table at the national or European level that could affect the border. Yeah. And that's why, of course, for instance, working at home last year, that was the top number one,
yes,
where people said you have to look into that.
And we're going to talk about that later on in this Congress as well. So then you have a subject, then how do you collect that data? What is the methodology?
Yeah, in fact, there are more steps. In the first place, you have to know what is the cross-border territory you are looking at. Of course, it's different if you say it is the whole Dutch, Belgium, Germany territory, or whether you say, for instance, it's only one particular euro region. Very often it's better to do that for a precise territory, because there the data situation is probably better than for the whole. So we say, for instance, that we look at now for the patients, we have a case of patients' mobility. What are effects of the situation today on the patient's mobility in the cross-border regions? There we say, yes, we look at the Belgian-Dutch situation and the German-Dutch situation in order to bring all the legislation together.
Right.
That's always a choice. We have to look into the also practical aspects.
Yes. And for whom then is that information? To whom do you speak to?
Yeah, in the first place, this is exactly what also Mr. Donner said. We would like to give more expertise to the region, to the cross-border region, bottom up, that we in the cross-border region better know what are the problems, effects, and probably who can solve it. The second is, of course, the national level. You could say there is a top-down idea. That's why we are so happy that after many years of lobbying, also the Dutch government has now an obligation within, as an agreement by the ministries, to look into border effects.
Which is unique, right, in Europe?
It is the first in the European Union, as we know.
And many more to come?
Hopefully. So it is there, more or less, you have to know in the border region what are the problems, but then, of course, also national government has also to look into problems, effects, and therefore they also need data. And our hope is that the first step, you have an obligation to do it, will lead to also a better data situation, that they also are looking into the question, how can we provide better data?
Yeah, how can we provide better data? That's good, because we made an animation movie, a short movie, to see how ITEM works.
The ITEM Cross-Border Impact Assessment. Why, what, and how are we doing it? Why? Legislation and policy made by regional and national governments and the European Union can affect cross-border mobility and border regions. For policymakers and citizens in border regions, it is often not so easy to assess such potential negative or positive effects. Therefore, ITEM developed its cross-border impact assessment. This methodology identifies and assesses cross-border effects of legislation and policy in different kinds and aspects. We do this preferably before this comes into force. It helps policymakers when making decisions on new policies and the effects on cross-border regions. How does our methodology work? First, we define the cross-border territory for the assessment. Depending on the research issue, this can be a Euro region, but it also can be demarcated as a much larger or smaller territory. Think of border regions all over Europe. Secondly, we establish principles, benchmarks, and indicators. Principles refer to desired circumstances, for example, to the situation that has been established in European legislation in which there is free mobility and non-discrimination of cross-border activities. Benchmarks are the standards that can be compared. An example is the previous situation or another region. Finally, the indicators allow us to interpret the consequences of legislation. Principles, benchmarks, and indicators derive from a number of values that are important in the EU context and are considered on those values. European integration. That is, the impacts on the freedom of citizens and companies with respect to the open border. Sustainable and socio-economic development of border regions. That is, how the regional development is affected by measures and open borders. And euregional cohesion. That is how the level and quality of cooperation and relation across the border is influenced. Let's focus on some of our results. Since its beginning, ITEM assessed the impacts on dozens of cases. For example, we assessed the impact of the proposal for a German federal law on an Autobahn mount. What would be the impact on the Euro region Mersey-Rhine? Next to the negative environmental consequences and cohesion for the villages around the border that were predicted, we concluded that Dutch and Belgian citizens were discriminated compared to German citizens. This was also the argument of the European Court of Justice to cancel the legislative project. Another example can be found in the Dutch Act to increase the lowest VAT rate. In this case, we predicted that the cross-border effects would be very limited, thus not worsening the economic competitiveness of entrepreneurs in the Dutch border region. Indeed, years later, the effects appeared to be negligible. A final example, based on the expectation that more people will work from home after the corona crisis, governments prepared new legislation to promote working at home. While the idea is that workers have a certain right to work from home, frontier workers are disadvantaged in terms of taxes and social security. Our methodology revealed these negative effects. The cases are diverse, from changes in tax treaties to passenger name records, from raising the retirement age to strategies on spatial planning, and from the introduction of tolling to COVID-19. Whether it deals with, amongst others, healthcare, security, environment, taxation, or climate, ITEM assesses the cross-border impacts for you. Do you want to know more? Feel free to contact us.
That's it about ITEM and the methodology. Reiner Steffens, do you think the data is underestimated in cases like this?
Not underestimated. Maybe to explain how, let's say, the Committee of the Region can contribute to data collecting and to work with kind of new data. So yeah. We in the Committee of the Region we set up 2 years ago a kind of new network where we intended to give regions and local administration a direct pathway to the European institutions, so and not filtered by political institutions in between. And we found 46 regions and municipalities all over Europe, for example, six of the Dutch provinces are part of our network, where we try to collect concrete evidence and daily experience with European law. Mm-hmm. And to give evidence to the lawmaker in Brussels. And what was a nice side effect after 2 years was that we suddenly discovered that there are many, many cross-border issues what the regions identified as a problem. So, which was not our intention from the beginning to work on cross-border problems directly, mm-hmm. but thanks University of Maastricht as well, we concentrated now more on asking questions while we do consultations on specific pieces of legislation.
Right.
For example, we examined the cross-border healthcare directive or the public procurement directives of the European Union. And there we suddenly we got good, evidence, good experience in cross-border issues. And this is now, task for the future of our network as well, to identify this more concretely and to give this to the legislature in Brussels to say, listen, here you can see concrete daily problems, cross-border problems, and this is kind of, data we collect and we can use for different purposes.
Yeah, how does it work with the organizations, Nathalie van Schelde? Because obviously, Mr. Steffen said, we understood and we find out that the relevance of that data, how does it work with your daily work and your organization?
Well, in DG Regio, we are the DG of the territories, including the cross-border territories, so we are very interested in the topic. However, European data is in the remit of Eurostat, but Eurostat tends to work with member states, and you collect data country by country.
Right.
And what we really miss, and I think DG Regio is playing a role in trying to resolve this, mm-hmm. partially,
right.
is the cross-border data, which looks at the territory, the joint territory, not just the Dutch part of the territory, the Belgian part of the territory, but actually the flows and what actually happens and what crosses the border, people and goods and services. So, what we do is that we, first of all, we try to promote existing practices. We work a lot with ITEM. We have some beautiful stories. For instance, I take another border, Belgium-France, where there are very comprehensive joint healthcare agreements between the two countries, which are based on more than 15, 20 years of data collection to mm-hmm. understand the state of health in the region, the commonalities, the differences, but also where the hospitals are and where treatment is needed and how we can then pool resources to make economies of scale. So these types of excellent initiatives we try to promote, mm-hmm. but we cannot ourselves decide that you should collect this and this and that.
Right.
But we really want to show how important it is because, I was very pleased to listen to Mr. Donner as well, but the ambitions that are being explained this morning will not be possible without knowledge, and knowledge also depends on data.
But that sounds so logic. Still, evidently, it's not. How to convince these policymakers to use this data and that information before working cross-border?
I think we need to do this in partnership, the different levels. I think everybody has been talking this morning about how important it is to recognize the role of each other. Mm-hmm. For instance, the work that ITEM does with the assessments is absolutely crucial and essential for to convince the politicians everywhere that this data is necessary. And hence, a little bit the surprise for us to hear recently that the statistics, the Netherlands, CBS, which has been very active in looking at cross-border data, mm-hmm. is possibly maybe going to stop doing that because the resources will no longer be there to do that. And for me, it's a little bit strange. On the one hand, to listen to the commitment that we must work together,
right.
And on the other hand, to not look at data together. So I'm hoping this is all not happening and that we will have a good solution in the end. But it's really important that we do this together all the way.
Right. In what way do you think, Martin, that Netherlands set the example of a sort of obligation working cross-border, then you need that data, that turns out also in other fellow countries?
Yes, I hope that also the experience in the Netherlands will a bit will be a promotion also for others. But we will have next week, by incidence, the first meeting or workshop with different ministries in The Hague, where we go, we show our, we have a guidance document how to do cross-border impact assessment, because there has to be a lot of awareness and also knowledge about the methodology. So my hope is that if the ministries will really start with the impact assessments, that they also discover more the problem of the data. And then hopefully there will be more pressure within the Dutch government to say, but we need more cross-border data. Mm-hmm. And I hope they will be then be proactive and go to their partners in the European Union and say, look, or in the Benelux and say, look, we have this methodology. Would that be not also something for you?
Right. What do you think, Reinhard Steffens? Will this be? Will it follow up in other countries like the Netherlands, as an example?
I mean, as we always need, let's say, good examples or good best practice examples. I'm quite sure that these need more kind of a promotion, but this could be attractive to other countries as well. But just let me mention, maybe you ask why should politicians be, let's say, keen to get data and to work with more data maybe than they did before.
Yes.
So thanks to the efforts of the European Commission in their better regulation procedures, they have set up now a procedure is called Fit for Future, where they try to make legislation more future-proofed. And we are happy that we, as the Committee of the Regions, are a part of this procedure. So we can, let's say, deliver directly data we gain from our consultations to the Commission colleagues directly, so that they, let's say, are obliged to listen to that what comes directly from the ground, from the regions and the municipalities, mm-hmm. so that they let's say, they won't, but they can't ignore anymore in the future legislation data which comes from us from
right
elsewhere.
Yeah, because in a way it's really strange that we still didn't do that before. Because if you like to address a problem, you need to know what that problem is based on facts. I mean, it's simple as that. Why do we all need to convince policymakers to do that? Do you think? Do we have an answer to that? No, not yet, maybe.
No, I think it's in the first place a structural problem.
Structural problem.
That the data collection is at the moment a pure national thing.
Yeah.
It stops at the border.
Yes.
And therefore you need another awareness of how we do that in the future also for cross-border territories.
Yes.
You need to convince the capitals that they have citizens who live close to the border, many borders in some cases, and that they interact with the other side, and therefore it matters. That's what you need to do. And can I just add that also from DG Regio's point of view, we have resources for this, because everybody will say, oh yeah, but this costs money, and you have to invest in collecting data and also making sure that you have the same definition of data sets across borders. We have Interreg programs. People who work along borders will know the Interreg programs.
Sure.
Well, we have made it possible now for the Interreg programs everywhere to be able to pool resources to do exactly this type of work. It's a choice, it's not obligatory, but it's there.
Yes, on methodology and facts and figures we spoke. Jacqueline, any questions or remarks on that online?
Yeah, hello, Sander. Yeah, there are a couple of reactions. Ik ga door in het Nederlands. Met name vanuit de veiligheidsregio Limburg-Noord. Ook vanuit de crisisdienst Lentes in Groningen. Dus het hele land kennelijk luistert ook mee. En met name ook het aandacht vragen voor wat hebben we geleerd vanuit die coronatijden. En waarom kan het nog niet actiever in praktijk blijken dat we die samenwerking oppakken. Als het over data gaat, wordt gezegd, er is heel veel data al open, maar doorontwikkeling in real-time data, dat is zeker nodig. Want vaak zijn de actuele data niet voldoende aanwezig om daar ook keuzes in te maken in de inhoudelijke onderwerpen.
Ja, could you comment on that maybe, Martin?
Yes, we will come, I think, later in the debate about the corona crisis, we will come to the question why it was so difficult also with respect to the comparison of data and definitions within the corona crisis. I think there we saw really that we have a problem.
Yes, yes. That's it for this moment. Thank you very much.